Hi everyone! Today on Blue World Academy, I'm going to be answering a bunch of viewer questions. Let me start by apologizing in advance for all the names I'm probably about to mispronounce. First, Tracy Murphy wants to know about my favorite sea animal. The thing is, I don't really have a favorite sea animal. There are just too many awesome creatures in the ocean to pick a favorite. I mean, if you think about it, how could you choose between an octopus, a shark, a dolphin, or a humpback whale? So I guess the answer is, my favorite animal is whichever animal I'm filming at that particular moment. I know that's not a very good answer, but... Along those same lines, Billy Cosgrove wants to know about my favorite shark. Now this one's a little easier. Although nothing can really compare to swimming with a shark the size of a bus, I would have to say that my favorite sharks are the hammerheads, because they just look cool. Naoki Sakine wants to know if I've ever been attacked by a shark or anything else. I did have one kind of scary encounter with a school of gray reef sharks once. I wrote a story about it that you can read on the Sea Stories section of our website. There's a link to it down below in the description. And I did get headbutted by an angry dolphin once. But for the most part, the only injuries I've sustained diving have been limited to sea urchin spines and a few jellyfish stings. Jonathan Venancio and Julian Zamora are both asking if I'm afraid of any sea animals, particularly sharks. The answer is not usually, because I find the ocean to be a continuous source of wonder and amazement. I've so rarely been threatened or injured by any animals that I'm really not afraid. However, that doesn't mean I'm not careful. When I'm diving around sharks, whales, or any other animal that's capable of hurting me, I try to be super vigilant to keep an eye peeled, and I always have another diver watching my back. And while animals like whales are really large and could easily harm divers, they tend to be super gentle and aware of their surroundings. I think the time I was most concerned for my safety was swimming with hunting sailfish because I was afraid I might get speared. But fortunately, they're really good at only spearing the fish they're chasing. Adam Fioris has noted that people are generally discouraged from feeding wildlife like bears. So is it a good idea to feed sharks? Let me tell you, this is definitely something that not all divers agree upon. First, I can tell you a fact, which is that there are not many accidents at all feeding sharks. As a general rule, it has a very good safety record. Some people suggest that the sharks view the people as competitors and do not associate them with the feeding. Others say that the sharks are smart enough to know which divers are carrying food down to feed them and which aren't. Shark feeding operations are done far from the beach, in places where swimmers are not likely to show up. It's just not very likely that sharks being fed regularly by divers on a reef are gonna somehow decide that means they should eat people up near a beach. The two places and events are totally unrelated. That does not, however, change the fact that sharks that are regularly fed might become partially dependent on people for food. And while this is a risk, I think it's balanced by the fact that those sharks, as ambassadors for their species, can help hundreds or even thousands of divers every year realize that sharks are not evil. We need sharks in the ecosystem. Their role cannot be understated. They're being hunted unsustainably in many cases just for their fins. Ultimately, changing how the public views sharks is critical to their protection, and I find that shark feeding operations are one of the best ways to help people understand and appreciate sharks. Thanks for your awesome questions, and please keep them coming. If you have a question you'd like me to answer, put it in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching Blue World Academy.
That all?